innings pitch, 18 strikeouts, and a 1.69 ERA.
Leadoff hitter for Fresno State is Miranda Rowletter. She takes a strike, 0-1. Rowletter, so far this year, 361 average. She's had a double and four triples so far. A little bit high for a ball, 1-1.
UCLA defense played very solid last game. They do a very good job making the routine play. Expect Joanna Grauer to challenge Fresno State hitters and throw a lot of strikes.
Grauer into a wine pitch, fouled back. So 1-2 is a count to Rowletter. She'll be faced by followed by Castellong, McKellon, Galvin, Hernandez, Minogue, Brodner, Broussard, Jennings, and then on the mound for Fresno State is Samantha Mejia. So Grauer into a wine, the pitch, a little bit high, dropped in off speed pitch.
Yeah, not a bad pitch. 1-2 up in the count. Able to throw something off speed. Looked like it might have missed a little bit inside, but good change of speeds. Gives the Fresno State hitter something to think about.
So Grauer into a wind on the pitch. A little excuse me foul tip towards the UCLA dugout.
Yeah, just trying to foul that one and stay alive right there. It was a good fastball up in the zone. She did a good job fighting that one off.
Rowletter with a lot of speed. Already 7 stolen bases on the season. A true leadoff hitter. Grauer into her wind on the pitch. Off the mitt of the catcher, Pack. So Taylor Pack in there. She's a junior catcher. She's got a lot of power.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. And Joanna Grauer will walk hitters. She has given up 12 walks in 20 innings of work so far this year, and she hits the leadoff hitter. Fresno State has a base runner here in the top of the first.
And Rowletter can turn that into a double pretty quickly. Like I said, she already has 7 stolen bases. Let's take a look at this one. Think it got her on the shoulder. We'll find out. Yeah, upper shoulder. That certainly doesn't feel good.
No, it does not. That one just got away from Grauer right there, not trying to have the leadoff hitter on. Now they got some speed on the bases. And, of course, Rowletter, she's in scoring position whenever she's on the bases.
Bunt right back to Grauer. Grauer looking up, throws to first base to Perez, coming over for second base. Good hustle by Perez, but Castellon does a good job advancing the runner.
Yeah, Castellon doing her job right there. Just trying to get the runner on first base over to second base in scoring position. Nice, easy sacrifice bunt executed well. Pitcher did a good job coming over, fielding her position, and the second baseman did a good job covering first.
Savannah McKellen will step in for the Fresno State Bulldogs. Grauer into her wine, a pitch. That's a strike, 0-1. McKellen has 4 home runs early on in the season. I was talking to people from Fresno State earlier, and they were telling me that this is a power-hitting team. These Bulldogs can really mash.
Yeah, especially in the middle of the lineup. You know, Grauer does have a base open right here. Doesn't want to give in to Fresno State's power hitter. Putting her on first base right here would not be the worst thing that can happen to UCLA.
UCLA pretty good defensively. They turned some double plays. So we'll see what happens. Very high rise ball, but McKellen can't lay off it. So it's 1-2. It's very early in the game, first inning. We're glad you've joined us on Flow Softball. We're here in beautiful Cathedral City underneath Mount San Jacinto. Grauer, indoor wind, and she delivers. Fouled back. You see the power right there. She was swinging for the fences.
Yeah, she no change in her approach here, down on the count, 1-2. And she has also shown that she will chase pitches out of the strike zone. That makes it a little bit easier for Grauer here ahead in the count.
Indoor wind the pitch, check swing, and I think she went, and yes, she did. Strike 3. So it looked like some sort of off-speed pitch right there, maybe a changeup. Yes, she did.
Yeah, not the pitch she was looking for, probably geared up for a fastball right there. Joanna Grauer in the driver's seat ahead in the count 1-2, and she was able to execute a nice off-speed pitch on the outside corner and got the hitter on the swing and miss.
Haley Galvin will step in for the Bulldogs. Takes a strike 0-1. She also has two home runs on the season. In the starting lineup for the Bulldogs, thus far this season, almost every single hitter on the team has at least one home run. Galvin finds herself behind 0-2. Leadoff hitter does not have a home run. Emily Brodner doesn't, and Caitlin Jennings doesn't. Everybody else has hit at least one home run. Riseball fouled off towards Fenway.
Grauer doing a good job here early in the first inning, getting Fresno State hitters to chase that rising fastball several times so far. She's gotten hitters to chase that pitch out of the strike zone.
Grauer's out of Pleasanton, California, a little bit north. Bay Area,
yeah. Very, very nice part of the Bay Area. Good part of California right there.
Misses low for a ball 1-2.
On the northwest coast.
Grauer, as a freshman, was 10-1 in 2015, 11-4 last year as a junior. Lines and pitches, off-speed pitch, just a little bit high. She really changed speeds on that.
Yeah, didn't miss by much, and Grauer has shown she's not afraid to throw that off-speed pitch in different parts of the count, done a good job for the most part hitting her spots. That one taken for a ball just off the plate.
Comes in with a 1.64 ERA. Fastball fouled off again. So they're making her work.
Yeah, Fresno State hitters not going quietly. But again, Brower's been able to keep her fastball outside of the strike zone when she's ahead of the count. And Fresno State has been doing a decent job helping her out.
Hard hit to left field, but very playable. Jordan with the catch, and that'll do it. So Fresno State gets a runner in scoring position, but can't put a run.
Samantha Mejia has to pitch to today. These hitters are very disciplined. Don't chase very many pitches out of the strike zone. They are very good in two-strike counts, fouling pitches off and making the pitchers work. It's not going to be an easy one here today for Samantha Mejia.
Mejia made four starts last year as a freshman. She went 3-1 with a 4.22 ERA. Facing off against Perez. Perez, 1-1 is the count to her. She kind of squared to bunt on that. She's batting a cool .422 so far on the season. A .481 on base percentage for the leadoff hitter for the Bruins. Mejia, indoor wine, a little bit high on the rise ball, 2-1. On the end. In the field behind Mejia, you got Minogue at first, Rowletter at second, Castellon at short, Broussard at third base, Jennings, Hernandez, and Galvin left to right on the outfield. Brodner behind the plate. And we've got a 3-1 count to Brianna Perez.
Yeah, Samantha Mejia quickly falling behind the leadoff hitter Perez. She does not want to walk the leadoff hitter here. UCLA does a great job.
Hitter's count, hard hit to center field, very playable. The center fielder Hernandez is under it, and we've got one down.
Yeah, good job by Samantha Mejia right there in the hitter's count, not afraid to challenge her. And Brianna Perez put a pretty good swing on it. Well, it got a routine fly ball to the center fielder.
So senior Kylie Perez will step in for the Bruins. Older sister of Brianna Perez comes into the game batting .439. Line drive out into center field, but again playable for Hernandez. Hernandez under it, makes the catch, and we got two down. So this is a good position for Mejia to be in. You want to get ahead of the UCLA hitters, pitch to contact. She had a lot of success in high school. She actually had a four-year varsity pitching career, 1.26 ERA in high school. Talented pitcher. Facing a very good UCLA team. Aaliyah Jordan stepping in. Takes a ball low, 1-0. So Aaliyah Jordan out of the San Diego area. She's batting 528 on the season with 20 RBIs already. Mejia winds and delivers. Inside corner for a strike, 1-1.
Yeah, good job by Samantha Mejia. Got the first two hitters out. Makes it a little bit more comfortable to hear pitching to the three-hole hitter Jordan with nobody on base.
A little bit outside for a ball, 2-1. Looks like she's keeping the ball low, which is good against these Bruin hitters.
Yeah, she's nibbling. Not throwing a lot of strikes early on, but she's not missing by very much.
That's a strike right there, 2-2. So Mejia coming into the game has struggled a little bit early on in the season. She doesn't get a lot of starts. Good pitch right there by Mejia. Swung on a missed strike three, and she gets through the UCLA order, 1-2-3.
In the bottom of the first, not very easy to go through the top of the UCLA lineup and get three up, three down. Good confidence builder and good momentum moving into the second inning here.
So stepping in for Fresno State is Vanessa Hernandez, the center fielder. Busy defensively in that first inning. Two catches out there in center field. She's coming in, batting 167. Laces a ball down the line and just foul. That had extra bases written all over it.
Yeah, didn't miss by much. But the umpire clearly in position. He was right on the left field line. Turned around, was able to see that ball. He had a better view than anybody. Count goes to 0-2.
Hernandez does have a home run and a double on the season, and that had double written all over it. Grauer and rewind the pitch off speed, very high. 1-2.
Not a bad pitch there, 1-2. First time the hitter saw something off speed in this at bat. Left it a little bit up, and it was a good take right there.
Grauer into a wind and the pitch. Grounded up the middle. Brianna Perez is going to have to hurry. Throws across the diamond. Washington stays on the bag. Good play by the UCLA first baseman. We got one down.
Yeah, also a nice play by the shortstop right there. You saw a nice, good, strong throw. She had to come up the middle to get that one. Set her feet, make a nice, strong throw to first base. First baseman did a good job keeping her foot on the bag.
So that'll bring up Rachel Minogue. He's got a .351 on base percentage, very disciplined hitter, drawing four walks thus far. Ducks out of a Grauer pitch, 1-0. So Grauer already hit one batter, and she was up and in on that one.
Yeah, she's consistently missed up here early and on, but also done a very good job battling back, working the sides, both sides of the plate.
That's a strike. So 1-1. Grauer has struck out 19 on the season. She's also walked 12. So she's a little bit wild, but very effective. Has a 1.59 ERA. Popped up. Looks like Perez is going to come over and make the catch on the infield, and we've got two down.
Good job by Grauer right there. Again, going right after Fresno State hitters. Nice easy pop fly to the third baseman for the second out of the inning.
So in her career, Grauer is 36-13 with a 3.5 ERA. So very successful career here so far, and she'll be facing the catcher, Emily Brodner. Brodner is a spot starter. She only has 9 at-bats thus far in the season. She's drawn 2 walks, has 1 hit and an RBI. Ground ball past the third baseman, but well foul. So 0-2.
Grauer in the driver's seat right here with the 0-2 count. Two outs in the top of the second. Nobody on base. A lot of different things she can do right here. Done a good job mixing in the off-speed pitch when she wants.
Indoor wind in the pitch. Very high on the rise ball. So that'll be 1-2. Brodner has struck out 5 times in her 9 at-bats, and she finds herself in a hole 1-2 with 2 outs here in the second inning. Strike three called. Delayed call by the umpire. And that'll do it for Fresno State. She came into the game struggling a little bit. Has a 2.05 whip, which for those people at home who don't know, walks, hits, in innings pitched. That's a strike, 0-1. So Tau Talafua, lots of power, four home runs early on in the season, 14 RBIs. Mejia, twists and winds, pitch off speed, very low for a ball, 1-1. So Mejia, as a freshman, she made 18 appearances, four starts, went 3-1. 24 strikeouts in 56 and a third innings pitched, fouled off, and that could have been trouble. That netting was in the right spot right there.
Yeah, fans all over the ballpark here today, sitting on the grass over there on the first base side. Definitely a line drive that was headed for the grassy hill, and that's why the netting's there.
It's definitely something that's been talked about, baseball and softball, the netting down the line. Big conversation topic. Fouled off towards the UCLA dugout.
Yeah, absolutely. You can get some real screaming line drives. It's very easy if you're not paying attention. Get caught off guard.
Great crowd on hand for both squads all the way around through the outfield as well. Mejia into her wind and the pitch. Outside for a ball. 2-2 is the count. Tau Talafua has a lot of power. So Mejia's going to try and be careful. She does pitch to contact, so might be problematic. Swung on and missed strike three. Just as I said, she pitches to contact, she throws the strikeout. So we got one down here in the bottom of the second inning.
Yeah, very nice pitch right there by Samantha Mejia. Had a 2-2 count, and she was able. That one out of the strike zone. Looked like it had a little bit of movement to the outside part of the plate, and the hitter unable to handle it first out of the inning.
That'll bring up Rachel Garcia, the designated player in this game, batting .385 thus far in the season. She had a couple hits earlier today.
Yeah, she was the flow game changer player of the game. She was 3-for-3 last game, also had two shutout innings, had a very big game, helped her team win earlier against Mizzou.
She has 10 RBIs on the season with a double. Mejia winds and delivers. Hard hit, but fouled back. And 1-1 is the count. Still no score early on in the game. It's only the bottom of the second inning. UCLA batting. They have one out. Beautiful setting. You see Mount San Jacinto in the background. Huge crowd down both lines around center field and even painted onto the wall in this nice complex. We're at Wrigley Field. A little bit low for a ball, 2-1. So Mejia came in a big situation. She notched a season-high 5 strikeouts in a 4-inning relief appearance in the NCAA Seattle Regional Elimination Game against Michigan last year. Garcia pops it up, but it's going to go foul. Crowd moving out of the way. Got to be ready when you come to a game. Do you ever bring your mitt when you come to a baseball
game?
Always
got to bring your mitt when you come to a baseball game. That's how you miss out on taking home a free souvenir.
So a good battle between Garcia and Mejia. 2-2 is the count with one out in the bottom of the second inning. Mejia twists and delivers. Hit hard down the line, but that's going to be foul too. Good effort by the Fresno State player. Hopefully she's all right. She did not feel the fence, went flipping over the fence. She's all right. That's a great effort.
Got to love that effort there, trying to make a big play for her team. Here
Jennings,
she is.
Look at Jennings. Full speed and flips over. Wow.
That's where the Fresno State catcher should be following that ball, tracking the ball, letting her left fielder know if she's going to have room or not. Nonetheless, very good effort by the left fielder. And she gives the thumbs up. She's going to be all right.
So how do you handle that? You said the catcher should be calling that out. But as a player, do you have your hand out to kind of, like, feel out the fence? Do you, like, feel it on your feet, like when you hit dirt? What do you do?
Yeah, when you're going to make a – when there's going to be a play where you're going to be at full speed, possibly dealing with the fence or a wall, catcher should get over to the fence as soon as possible, get a good angle of the ball, and be communicating whether you're going to have room to make the play or not. She was in a part of the ballpark there where the warning track – a little bit shorter, the fence gets on you quick. But overall, good effort. Probably would have liked to hear a little bit more from her teammates. Nonetheless, good effort, and she's ready to go.
So 2-2 is still the count after that long fly ball. Mejia indoor wind and delivers. Fouled back behind us. So we'll do it again. 2-2. That's got to be great for a pitcher, knowing that you have players out there that are going to go all out for you.
Yeah, absolutely. You have a lot more confidence as a pitcher to challenge hitters with strikes when you know your defense can play behind you. When you see your defense behind you putting out that kind of effort, you have a lot of confidence up there on the mound.
A little bit low for a ball, 3-2. Mejia's trying to keep the ball low. Brodner, the catcher, does a great job defensively, looking for a sign. So everybody's on the same page, looking at their wrists. So the 3-2 pitch hit hard off of her foot. That certainly did not feel good. Rachel Garcia is going to limp on her way back to the dugout.
And that one stings. There's not a lot of padding on your foot. Obviously a lot of bones in there. You can see right off the top of her foot there, that one stings. Definitely going to be some bone bruising on that.
The crowd goes very silent because UCLA fans know Rachel Garcia is an integral part, not only at the plate but also on the mound, and she's in a lot of pain. She's trying to walk it off, and she's going down the third base line parallel with the line, so all the way down past third base. I don't know if this is something that you go back in the game for.
Yeah, it's hard to say. She's able to walk. Probably nothing broken in there, just has to walk it off. It's going to sting for a while. She will have a nice bruise on the top of her foot. She will be feeling that one for a while. You can see that one actually off the top of her ankle. Not a lot of padding there, a lot of bone, a lot of things that can easily get bruised. But she walked it off. She looks like she's going to try it out, going to put the ankle guard on there to make sure that doesn't happen again. And she's ready to go.
Obviously, you were a baseball player. You've had a lot of experience. What does something like that feel? How many days does it take to get out over something like that?
Depending on how hard the ball hit her ankle, that can last for up to a week. Certainly the next couple days, getting out of bed in the morning is not going to be very easy after the leg's been sitting there. It allows the chance the muscles to get tight. Definitely has to keep it loose and keep ice on it.
She's going to draw the walk. And let's see if Coach goes to a pinch runner on that. Yeah, and I think she's going to. So we have a pinch runner coming out. Actually, no, they're going to talk strategy. So stepping in is Bubba Nichols for the Bruins, and she's going to trade that shin guard with Rachel Garcia. Garcia giving it to Bubba Nichols, who's quite the hitter. 2 home runs, 2 triples, and a double thus far on the season. 8 RBIs. Takes low for a ball. So Samantha Mejia trying to work her way out of this one-out jam. Mejia has 5 siblings. Ground ball foul. Erica, Crystal, Alex, Brianna, and Caitlin. A little shout out to the family.
Yeah, absolutely. I think she was a little early on that pitch, able to foul it off down the third baseline.
So we saw Nichols in the first weekend of the Mary Nutter Collegiate Classic hit a home run. Mia winds and delivers a little bit low again, 2-1.
Looks like she's trying to avoid giving Nichols a fastball to hit over the plate. Some off speed right there, down and in. A good take by Nichols.
So everybody checking their wrist guard on the same page. Mia winds and delivers. Ground ball very foul, and that hit off the net as well. Almost hit some of our cameramen over there.
Yeah, look out. She is not overmatched by the fastball. A little bit ahead of that one.
Get a good laugh from our cameramen.
Yeah, he didn't even flinch.
We got a good crew out here today, and we thank everybody back in the truck and on the field with the camera. Great production here at Flow Softball. So Mejia, she winds and delivers. Off-speed pitch a little bit inside. Tough take for Bubba Nichols.
Yeah, I like the pitch selection there by Samantha Mejia. Bubba Nichols has been ahead of the fastball. She goes off-speed right there, but misses inside.
Bruins still have a runner on first. That's Garcia. One out in the inning. Full count. Grounder again foul down the line. So she's been out ahead of it. If you're the catcher, what are you calling?
Well, if Samantha Mejia has confidence in that off-speed pitch, I definitely think she can get Nichols out on her front foot. She's unable to stay back on the fastball. It's going to be even more difficult for her to stay back on the off-speed. But she, Mejia has had problems locating that off-speed pitch here in this at-bat.
So Mejia with 20 strikeouts to 16 walks on the season. Line drive, that's going to get into the gap in right center field. Garcia around second to third. She's going to be held up. Bubba Nichols with a double, and UCLA's got two runners in scoring position with one out.
That's a nice piece of hitting right there by Bubba Nichols. Looked like Samantha Mejia did give her something off speed to hit. Left it up a little bit in the zone. And good job by Bubba Nichols, not trying to do too much. Just hit the ball where it was pitched. Got it in the right center gap. Good job by Rachel Garcia going first to third. And she is a sack fly away from putting the Bruins on the board.
Really good contact. Ball moving away from the center fielder to the gap. Garcia showing no ill effects from that ground ball off her shin. And there's a line drive. That's going to fall right in front of the left fielder, Jennings. One run's in. The second run is out at the plate. Great throw by Jennings to Brodner to cut down the runner at home.
Yeah, great throw by the left fielder. Put the ball right there on the catcher. And that's a nice, easy tag. Big out for Fresno State, preventing the second run from scoring.
So Taylor Pack knocks in one run, but Jennings to Brodner to rob the Bruins of another. Great play by Fresno State. And that'll bring up Zoe Shaw for the Bruins, who's batting .389 on the season. Takes low for a ball, 1-0. We've seen some great defense thus far in the tournament.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we've seen one error in just in two games to this point. All the teams here in the Mary Nutter Classic have been playing very well behind their pitchers.
Hard hit to right center field. That's not going to drop. So Zoe Shaw with a hit advances on the throw, and UCLA's got two runners in scoring position.
Yeah, that ball probably one that should have been caught. That's a tough play for the second baseman going over her shoulder trying to make the play. Looked like the center fielder didn't get a good read on it right off the bat. Either way, that one falls in no man's land.
Tough ball. The second baseman going out can't quite get to it. Center fielder not quite there. And good base running by the Bruins. So we're having a conference in the circle. It looks like Mejia is going to stay in. They do have somebody warming up beyond right field. So this might be an outing for Mejia that's only going to be a couple innings.
She's done a pretty good job to this point. These UCLA hitters, they are tough. They are not easy outs, not chasing a lot of pitches out of the strike zone. She's battling.
Now batting for UCLA.
But UCLA in business here in the bottom of the second inning.
So 1-0 UCLA after the dust settles, and Kinsley Washington steps in. the very talented freshman first baseman for the Bruins, batting a cool 367 from the nine spot. Takes high and away, 1-0. Certainly as a manager, you love to see that, the nine-hole hitter hitting almost 400.
Yeah, when you have that much offense in your lineup where your nine-hole hitter's hitting 400, you're probably going to score a lot of runs.
A little bit outside for a ball, 2-0. There still is a base open for Fresno State. We'll see what Mejia does. Kinsley Washington coming in. So far on the season, she also has four stolen bases. So 3-0 is the count so far. That's going to bring the catcher, Brodner, out to the circle to talk to Mejia. So this is tough, 3-0. If you're a hitter, are you taking all the way?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what the coach puts on, whether they let her swing away, whether they want her taking. There is a base open, and the leadoff hitter, Brianna Perez, is on deck. So it's got to be one pitch, probably looking for a fastball down the middle, and if it's not that, nothing wrong with taking a pitch right here.
And she was taken all the way, it looks like. So Washington still ahead in the count, 3-1, with two runners in scoring position. And Brianna Perez, the freshman, is on deck, batting 413. So Mejia into her wind, big pitch here. A little bit low, and she walked her.
Good plate discipline right there by Kinsley Washington. That pitch didn't miss by much, looked like it was a little down and out. But now UCLA really putting the pressure on. Base is loaded, and the leadoff hitter, Brianna Perez, coming to the plate.
Brianna Perez.
So Fresno State has pitchers in the bullpen warming up. Brianna Perez stepping in. Talked to her before the game. She was studying late for midterms. Mejia misses outside. Yeah, the base is loaded and two outs. But we don't talk enough about these girls being student athletes and how much time they got to put in on and off the field. Mejia winds. Ball's hit, and it's going to be placed right into right field. That looks like it's going to be two. Two runs across. They're going to hold Washington at third, but the Bruins get two runs, and they now lead 3-0.
Nice piece of hitting right there by Brianna Perez. And that's a big reason why you didn't want to walk Kinsley Washington in the at-bat before.
Kylie Perez.
Samantha Mejia having to go through the toughest part of the UCLA lineup right here. Nice piece of hitting. Just dropped the head of the bat to the ball. Was able to poke it over the first baseman's head for a two RBI double.
Older sister Kylie Perez still has two runners in scoring position. She swung on that one, tried to check her swing to no avail. So it's 0-1. 3-0. UCLA leading Fresno State. Two runners still in scoring position. Kylie Perez has raised her average to 429. Fakes like she's going to bunt. She takes for a ball, 1-1. So Kylie Perez, the senior, on track to possibly break some records at UCLA. Fouls it off down towards Yankee Stadium. So 1-2.
Yeah, this is going to be a big out right here for Fresno State if they can get out of it, facing the middle of the UCLA lineup with runners in scoring position. They have a chance to really break this one open here early in the ball game. It's a big at-bat right here.
Perez behind in the count, 1-2 with two outs. Takes very high for a ball to even the count, 2-2. Now, you do have a base open. So how does that play into strategy?
There is a base open, meaning if they put the hitter on right here, creates a force out at every base, but as we both know, the on-deck hitter, not an easy out as well.
Swung on and missed strike three. So Mejia pitches herself out of a jam from them.
Yeah, absolutely, but expect Joanna Grauer here to pitch with a lead. She's going to go right after these Fresno State hitters. She knows she's got a solid defense behind her, and she wants to let them help her get these outs any way she can.
So Grauer misses high on the first pitch, 1-0. Gets her sign and goes into the wind. And the 1-0 pitch, up high again. You know, we started to talk about it during the break. These players have midterms coming up this week, and they've been up late studying on top of playing softball.
Yeah, being a collegiate athlete is a full-time job. Whenever you're not on the field, there's a very good chance, if you're not practicing or training or in the weight room, that you're in the classroom or studying for a test. Not a lot of downtime for collegiate athletes, and that's what makes it even more special when you make it to this level. They work very hard both on and off the field.
Grauer into her wind in the pitch. Hard hit ball down the line, and that's going to be fair into the corner. Roussard over to second. Is she going to think about third? No, she's just going to arrive standing up at second with a double, and Fresno State's got the leadoff runner on here in the third inning.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Was able to get that one just inside the first baseline. You see, nice, easy, compact swing. Hit it where it was pitched. First baseman was unable to make a play on it. Fresno State in business with the leadoff hitter on second base.
So runner in scoring position for Caitlin Jennings, the left fielder. Jennings, who made a spectacular play in left field, great throw, squares the bunt. She lays down a good one. Grauer has one play to first, and she has to hustle, makes the play. Textbook bunt by Jennings, and we've got one down.
Yeah, good job by Jennings, getting the runner over to third base with less than two outs. Now a sack fly can score that runner on third base. Also a good job by Grauer, fielding her position, seeing the bunt early, getting out of the circle and making a nice throw to first base.
Rowletter steps in. She was hit by a pitch in her first at-bat. That looks like it's going to be a sack fly deep into left center field. Runner will score easily, and Fresno State cut the lead to two.
Yeah, and that's where the sacrifice bunt comes into play. She was able to get the runner from second to third, and all it took was a fly ball to get Fresno State on the board. Well, good execution right there by Fresno State.
Runner scores without a throw. So Fresno State playing a very tough UCLA team, number three. But Fresno State, you know, their record is very deceiving, 7-6, but they've played some tough competition.
They have. It's good for them early in the season. Get to play some of the top teams in the country. They're playing them tough. They've lost a few very close ball games. But you can see they are a good softball team.
So they've lost a couple in a row. They've lost to Wisconsin, LSU, and BYU. But they've had chances in each of those games. Wisconsin, they went extra innings. Earlier in the season, they beat Purdue and Notre Dame. Also Stanford. So they're a really solid team.
Yeah, absolutely. Very good practice early in the season to play a lot of good competition, especially when you're playing them as tough as they are.
So Grauer has given up her first run of the game. Hard hit ball down the line. Look out, crowd. So 2-2 is the count. Top of the third, Fresno State put a run across. There's still two outs in the inning. Castellon sacrificed in her first at-bat, batting .368 on the season. She does have three home runs, and you kind of saw the power on that one she turned on. Grauer low, good stop by Pack. Castellon playing shortstop for the Bulldogs. 10 RBIs on the season. Takes low for a ball, works a walk. And Fresno State is a bit in business again.
Yeah, good job taking an off-speed pitch down right there. Not what Joanna Grauer wanted to do in that situation with two outs.
Come for the Bulldogs, number 24.
Now they have a runner on first base here, top of the third inning.
Savannah McKellen stepping in, the designated player for Fresno State. She struck out in her first at-bat. Grauer high with the ball, 1-0. McKellen batting .306. again with the power. Four home runs so far on the season.
Yeah, she did show in her first at bat. She will chase pitches out of the strike zone, but definitely takes a big, strong, healthy hack at them.
Foul ball back towards Fenway. So McKellen actually came from Georgia, transferred from Northwest Florida State College. She's a senior, 5'5 right-handed hitter. Hard hit again down the line. Look out, crowd. Good play by one of the fans on a blanket. One hops it, gets it into the infield. We got to sign that guy up.
Yeah, nice play over there. Heads up. Didn't need a glove. Put two hands on it. And then he made a nice throw to the shortstop.
Yeah, hit the cutoff, man.
Great execution right there.
So we'll do it again. Two strikes on the hitter, on McKellen. Off-speed pitch down in the dirt. Good job by the catcher, Pack, to keep it in front of her.
And as you said earlier in the game, Joanna Grauer does throw some balls. She will walk hitters.
This season, 20 strikeouts, but 13 walks. 13 walks and 23 and a third. Indoor one, she pitches. Hard hit to the second baseman. Perez can't come up with it. It goes into right field. On to third. Good throw, and they got her. Great throw by the right fielder, Zoe Shaw.
End of the inning.
Zoe Shaw with a wonderful throw. Third baseman didn't have to move her glove at all.
No, perfect strike right on the bag. Again, that's the one as a right fielder you dream about.
Leah Jordan stepping in for the Bruins takes extraordinarily high, 1-0.
Yeah, that one looked like it got away from her a little bit.
Brodner did a good job stepping up and jumping up to make that catch.
Absolutely.
Good catchers involved today in this game, Pack and Brodner. Mejia indoor wind in the pitch. A little bit outside for ball 2-0. And Aaliyah Jordan batting 514 on the season, three home runs, two triples, and four doubles. 973 slugging percentage. Mejia winds and delivers. A little inside, so 3-0 to the leadoff hitter, Jordan.
Yeah, the last thing Mejia wants to do right here is walk the leadoff hitter after they just scored a run in the previous inning.
So still activity in the Fresno State bullpen just beyond right field. Mejia indoor wind, and that's high for a ball. So Aaliyah Jordan draws a walk. That's her ninth on the season, and that'll bring up Tau Talafua.
Yeah, she was able to draw the walk on four straight pitches, not what Samantha Mejia wanted to do to the leadoff hitter, and now having to face one of the power-hitting players for the UCLA in Brianna Tau Talafua.
And Jordan can run on first base. She does have two stolen bases on the season. Foul ball way back. That's a major league foul ball right there.
Yeah, she took a big swing at that one. I think she was looking for one pitch. She was trying to hit it over the fence. Like, she wasn't able to get on top of that fastball, but definitely took a big hack at it.
Tau Talafua with a 675 slugging percentage. She got four home runs on the season. Takes low in the dirt. Jordan doesn't advance on that. Another good play by Brodner. So Mejia finds herself in a little bit of trouble here. Nobody out, leadoff runner on. Tau Talafua up at the plate. 1-1 is the count. And that's a strike. 1-2 is the count. UCLA with a lead, 3-1 over the Fresno State Bulldogs here at the bottom of the third inning. Sun starting to come out over on our side of the field. A little bit outside, evens count, 2-2. Tau Talafua struck out in her first at-bat, 0-1. So 2-2. Mejia living a little bit dangerously to the power-hitting third baseman for the Bruins. Hard hit ball, but that's going to be foul down the left field line. That was a good display of her power, though.
Yeah, another good, strong, healthy hack. She's not afraid to swing for the fences here, even with two strikes on her.
So ahead of that a little bit. So do you expect off speed?
If I was Samantha Mejia, I'd probably want to go something soft away.
Said she goes high and fast, and that's hit onto Yankee Stadium. That actually almost hit the lights above our field.
Yeah, you can see she is on the fastball. I think something off speed right here might catch her off guard. But again, we'll see. She's taking big hacks, even with two strikes here in the count.
There's outside, slowing away. You were right about that. Tau Talafua showing plate discipline, laying off on that. Tau Talafua does have 7 strikeouts thus far on the season. So far today, UCLA is 4-for-5 with runners on base. Hard hit again, and very hard hit down the line over towards Yankee Stadium. Umpire calling for a couple more softballs, and we'll do it again, full count. Runner on first base, bottom of the third inning, nobody out. Mejia into her wind and the pitch up high. That looked like ball 4. But we'll do it again. Still full count, 3-2.
She's been hitting a lot of these foul balls pretty hard foul. She is on the fastball.
Hard hit again down the line. And that's going to go foul, 3-2.
She can straighten one of these out. She's going to hit it a long ways. Again, early on the fastball. Mejia not backing down, continuing to challenge.
Tau Talafua out of Carson. Grounds the ball at the middle. This might be 2. Short on to second, and good slide by Aaliyah Jordan. So Bulldogs only able to get 1, and there's 1 down.
Very nice job by Samantha Mejia. After Tau Talafua fouled off several, she hits a hard ground ball to the shortstop. They're able to get the lead out. It was a nice slide there into second base by Aaliyah Jordan to break it up.
So I'll bring up Rachel Garcia, who fouled the ball hard off her shin earlier in the game. Hard hit up the middle, and that's going to be a base hit. That's going to go into left field. So UCLA has runners on first and second, and we only have 1 down.
Yeah, good piece of hitting right there by Rachel Garcia. Looking for 1 pitch there early in the count. And she was able to handle it, hit it very hard right over the shortstop's head. And they have runners on first and second with 1 out here in the bottom of the third inning.
So Bubba Nichols will step in from Merced. She's a sophomore.
Number 48, Bubba Nichols.
Her freshman year, she batted .282, had 10 home runs. Did have a home run earlier in the Mary Nutter Collegiate Classic. In the dirt, good block by the catcher, Brodner. And Mejia kind of puts her hand to her chest saying, my fault, I missed on that. So Mejia grabs a little bit of dirt, gets the ball a little bit dirty, and checks her wrist. See what the pitch is. Bruins have runners on first and second. Hard hit, but foul down towards the UCLA dugout. Now, both of us grew up playing baseball, and I don't know about you. I'm so used to the catcher going down and flashing fingers and whatnot. Does it throw you off with the wrist guard?
You know, it's a little bit different, but obviously be a lot of information on those wrist guards. It's got to be essential in making sure the pitcher, the catcher, the rest of the defense are all on the same page. Everybody knows what's going on. Defense.
Hard hit ball to left field, very playable. Left fielder Jennings makes the catch, and we have 2 down.
The defense is also able to adjust themselves based on whether they know what pitch is coming, what location.
Do you ever see that becoming bigger in baseball?
You know, you see it happen at the lower levels right now. You know, you see it some in Little League, not so much in high school. It could be something that some programs adopt. But again,
hard hit ball in the left field. Jennings can't make the catch. Pack is going to be into second. Let's see what they do. Garcia's coming to the plate. She's going to score standing up. And the Bruins take a 5-1 lead. So catcher Taylor Pack had a single earlier in the game, and now she finds herself on second with a double and two RBIs.
Yeah, that's a big hit with two outs for the Bruins right there. She was sitting fastball all the way. Left fielder looked like she might have had a chance for it off the bat. The ball just hit too hard, skipping all the way, you can see here, to the back fence. And the second runner also scoring easily standing up.
And Garcia showing no ill effects from that ball she hit off her shin. It's a meeting on the mound, or at the circle, I should say. I thought for a second that might have been it for Mejia. But they're going to stay with her, and she's going to face Zoe Shaw with Taylor Pack still at second base. There is two outs in the inning. Be a strike, 0-1. And Shaw's already had a single in the game. She also made that really nice throw earlier in the game from right field. But he is struggling a little bit. Off-speed pitch, it's fouled down the line. So she's ahead in the count, 0-2. Mejia has given up five earned runs to this very good UCLA team, number three in the nation. And we said before that Fresno State, even though their record is 7-6, it's really misleading.
Yeah, they've been playing teams tough. They've played a very fundamentally sound ball game to this point. Samantha Mejia is not doing a bad job. This UCLA lineup, top to bottom, as you talked about earlier, even the nine hitter, being a 400 hitter in this lineup, one of the toughest lineups in the country to pitch to.
You really don't see any holes in the lineup.
There are no holes in the lineup. Everybody is a threat. They all have very good plate discipline. They're not helping Samantha Mejia out at all.
Ground ball to the hole. Shortstop's going to have to hustle across the diamond. Scooped in. First baseman Minogue tried to make the scoop. Can't do it. Think they're going to give an E6 on that play.
Yeah, not a routine play for the shortstop right there. Soft ground ball. She knew she had to get it out of her glove very quickly. You can see as soon as she feels it, she tries to get rid of it. Not able to get a lot on it. And it wasn't enough. First baseman unable to dig it out of the dirt. UCLA now threatening with runners on first and third.
We'll see how the official scorer rules that. They're taking a look at it. They haven't announced it yet. They are going to give it an error. So E6 on that. Bruins have runners on the corner. There's still two outs, but they've got a 5-1 lead. And it looks like Fresno State's going to stick with Mejia. So Kinsley Washington stepping in with before the Bruins. She drew a walk in her first at-bat. So far today, UCLA 3-for-6 with two outs and 3-for-6 with runners in scoring position. So first pitch, ball, 1-0. And we saw from Missouri the difference between Missouri and UCLA earlier in the day was Missouri couldn't get that big hit. UCLA is getting a number of big hits with runners in scoring position. Washington pops it up. Three people coming together. Jennings makes the catch. The left fielder calls off the shortstop and center fielder, and that'll do it.
Galvin.
So Grauer so far in the game. She has two strikeouts. Her career high for strikeouts in a game is 10. I don't think she's going to get there today. Galvin takes inside for a ball, 1-0. So both schools from California, Fresno, Central Valley, UCLA down in Westwood on the west side of Los Angeles. Off-speed pitch, just a little bit inside for a ball, 2-0. always remember Fresno State for their, they had a football game against USC back in the Reggie Bush days where they almost got the Trojans, who were number one in the country at the same time. So that'll be 3-0.
Yeah, Fresno State produces a lot of professional athletes in a lot of their sports. Very good athletic program.
So 3-0 is the count, and being behind four runs, I'm expecting a take right here. And she is taking all the way, and that's a strike, 3-1. Now with a four-run deficit, do you give her the green light, 3-1, or?
She's looking for one pitch right here. It's got to be that one pitch that she's looking for, above all.
And she hits that ball well to left field. Back goes the left fielder. That ball is gone. Home run, Haley Galvin. That's her third on the season. And Fresno State has cut the lead to 3.
And there's that one pitch in that count that you're looking for. She was looking for a fastball over the middle of the plate that she can drive. Probably the only pitch she's looking for in that 3-1 count. And she did not miss it. Nice piece of hitting right there. Brings the Bulldogs within 3. Fastball up and in. Nice, quick, compact swing. That one was gone off the bat.
That'll bring up number 10, Vanessa Hernandez.
So Vanessa Hernandez, the center fielder, will step in. You know, we were talking to Fresno State people before the game, and they talked about the power on this team, and that was on full display by Haley Galvin with a long home run to left field, and Vanessa Hernandez stepping in. She also has a home run on the season. So you can't miss with a pitch against these Bulldogs.
No, Joanna Gower having to be very careful. When she misses, she does not want to miss over the plate.
That ball's hard hit to the gap in left center, and that ball is gone. Line drive, home run by Vanessa Hernandez, and the Bulldogs have cut the lead to 2.
And as we were just talking about, when you miss over the plate to this Bulldog lineup, they can hit the ball over the fence. Back-to-back home runs now for Fresno State, and they are right back in this ballgame.
A line drive shot for Vanessa Hernandez. That ball did not get very high off the ground, just crushed it.
Another fastball up in the zone, not where Joanna Grauer wants to be. She wants to be... She's going to miss. She wants to miss off the plate or down low. If you miss up, this Fresno State lineup certainly capable of hitting the ball. Fresno State facing a lot of the top teams in the country. And you can see right here, they are not overmatched by UCLA, who's ranked number 3. They're playing them very tough, and they are very much still in this ballgame.
Ta Milo starts Minogoff with a high outside pitch, 0-1. Minogue is batting .219 so far in the season. She popped up to the shortstop in her first at-bat. And that's a strike, 1-1. So UCLA ranked number 3 in the country. Fresno State lost to LSU, which was ranked number 7 in the country. A little bit high for a ball, 2-1. Ta Milo was really trying to put something on that. She like really grunted, almost like one of those tennis players you hear as she threw the ball.
Absolutely, trying to get a little bit more behind that pitch. She's doing a good job, at least when she's missing down out of the zone, staying out of the danger zone.
Ground ball to Washington, she'll take it to the bag herself, and we've got one down.
Good job coming in. Getting the leadoff hitter out. Nice, easy ground ball there to the first baseman. Took 2 steps to her left, fielded it cleanly, and was able to take the bag herself.
Tom Milo, number 18, right-hander from Murrieta, California. In her career, 39-8. So that'll get it done, 327. Two-thirds inning pitch in her career. She's facing Brodner, the catcher, who's had a very good day at the plate. Plays a very good defensive catcher. Swings and misses on that one. One out in the fourth inning, top of the fourth inning, 5-3 UCLA leads. Selena Taamilo coming in relief of Joanna Grauer. It's another strike and strike three called.
Good job. Taamilo going right after the hitters. Three straight pitches there to get the strikeout. You can see buckles her knee, not what she was looking for right there. Very good job throwing a strike in the bottom of the strike zone.
Taamilo has 257 strikeouts in her career to only 135 walks. Starts off with a ball right there, 1-0. So UCLA also has activity still back there in the bullpen just beyond left field. Off-speed pitch for a strike, 1-1. So we've seen a lot of the pitchers today locate that changeup very successfully.
Yeah, and the biggest difference between Taamilo and Joanna Grauer, the starting pitcher for UCLA, Taamilo doing a very good job keeping that ball in the bottom of the strike zone, not allowing the Fresno State hitters to get extended and get that barrel to the ball.
Broussard doubled in her first at-bat. She's 1-for-1. She's got a .344 batting average this season. Finds herself in a hole, 1-2. Pops it up. It's going to go foul right behind us. So we'll do it again, 1-2, here with two outs in the top of the fourth inning. Broussard also has power, two home runs thus far on the season. We've seen the Bulldogs' power on display this inning.
Yeah, absolutely. Taamilo doesn't want to give in here. She's ahead in the count, 1-2. Hitter still has to hit her pitch.
Off-speed pitch a little bit high for a ball. Tough pitch to lay off.
Yeah, good pitch in the 1-2 count. She still has a couple pitches to play with right there. Tried to get the hitter to chase something up and out of the zone. But a good take by the Fresno State hitter.
Winds and delivers. Fouled off down above the first base dugout. Taamilo last year was 14-0 with a .283 earned run average. Tied for the second most wins without a loss in one season for a Bruin pitcher. Anytime you can say I had the second most of anything in a UCLA softball career, that's impressive.
Pack absolutely.
Drops a pop out, tough play. You're looking in the sun, the way the sun is right now, position. Taylor Pack trying to make that play over against the screen, and you kind of see she almost couldn't find it at first and then just drops it.
Yeah, not an easy play for the catcher to make, getting out of the crouch position, having to look up and find the ball immediately, also having to worry about the fence coming into play.
Hard hit down the first baseline and foul. So 2-2 is the count here with two outs in the top of the fourth. And that was kind of an example, too. You have the first baseman coming in and the catcher going over. Does the first baseman call off the catcher in a situation like that?
The first baseman does have priority. If she doesn't think she can catch the ball, she can certainly allow the catcher to have a chance on it. On that one, it looked like she had a good beat on it. Just was unable to make the play.
Off-speed pitch freezes her, gets her looking. So Broussard down on strikes. And that'll send up Brianna Perez to the plate. She doubled in her last at-bat. So 1-for-2 so far today. Hits the ball hard down the first base line, just foul by about 5 feet. So 0-1. Perez, of course, a very talented freshman. Younger sister of Kylie Perez, who is on deck. So Brianna Perez has a double on the season, not known for her power, but she gets on base often.
Yeah, very good leadoff hitter. She finds ways to get on base any way that she can.
Hits the ball hard to left field, very playable for Jennings. She's under it, makes the catch, and we got one out.
It's always nice to get that first out of the inning there for Samantha Mejia. Brianna Perez is not an easy out. Very tough out there at the top of the UCLA lineup.
Next up for the Bruins, number 8.
See, nice, Abby easy Perez. Routine fly ball there for the center fielder. Big first out here for Fresno State.
So Kylie Perez is stepping in for the Bruins. Mejia's battled all day against this very, very, very difficult UCLA lineup that really doesn't have any holes. Mejia, her ERA has gone up to 7.3. Gets ahead in the count to Kylie Perez, 0-2. So far on the season, Mejia 0-1. In 23 innings, she has struck out 21. Grips the ball, winds and delivers. Very high on the rise ball. So 1-2.
I think she was probably trying to miss up and out of the zone on that one in the 0-2 count. Probably missed a little bit higher than she wanted to. But again, these UCLA hitters very disciplined at the plate.
Perez checks her swing. So that'll even the count, 2-2. So what's interesting is when they make the call with those wristbands, it's not just the pitcher getting the call, it's also the infielder taking a look at her wrist. Hard hit into right field. That's going to drop. That's going to be extra bases. Kylie Perez around first. She's going to second. She's going to hold at second with a stand-up double.
Very nice piece of hitting right there by Kylie Perez. Went down. Got a pitch low. In the strike zone, drop the head of the bat. Nice line drive into the right field corner. Nothing the right fielder can do on that one. That one was double all the way. UCLA in business here with a runner on second base and one out.
Leah Jordan hits a foul ball over towards some fans down the third base line. 5-3. UCLA in front. They got a runner in scoring position with one down. Leah Jordan, the number 3 hitter for the Bruins. Lots of power, 4 doubles, 2 triples, and 3 home runs on the season. Mejia has to be very careful pitching to Leah Jordan. Jordan walked in her last at-bat. Average at 5.14. Mejia under a wind and pitch, a little bit low for a ball. So 2-1. So 2-1 with one out in the inning. What's the strategy here?
Well, they have first base open to the dangerous hitter. But the hitter on deck, Brianna Tautafula, no easy out either.
Fouled off. So evens count 2-2.
Still doesn't have to give in to her right here. Still has first base open. If they put her on base, they have the double play in order.
Mejia comes from Bakersfield, California, Ridgeview High School. Bakersfield about an hour and a half south of Fresno. Hard hit ball to right field. Did Jordan get enough of it? She did not. Catch by Galvin. She'll throw it in. Perez easily tagging, moving to third. But Jordan just got under that, and we got two outs.
Yeah, didn't miss that one by much. Might have got it a little bit in on the hands. Wasn't able to get the barrel to the ball and drive it. Just a long fly ball out for the second out of the inning.
So there's no wind today here in Cathedral City. Last weekend there was a lot of wind, swirling wind, so balls that probably should have been just traditional fly balls were going out of the ballpark.
Yeah, the wind can change very quickly here.
Tautafula, pop fly, shortstop over to make the catch, and that'll do it. So UCLA gets a runner in scoring position on a double by. She's from Rancho Cucamonga. for those of you at home. That's about an hour down the 210 from here. Tom Elo with a pitch, a little bit outside for a ball. 1-0 is the count to Caitlin Jennings. She's a junior, 5'3", left-handed hitter. Fairly open stance. Tom Elo, indoor wind and delivery. Off speed, a little bit high for a ball, 2-0.
Tom Elo does not want to fall behind the hitter right here. She wants to pitch with a lead. Let the defense play well behind her. Very strong defensively.
That's a strike. So 2-1 is the count. So Tom Elo's got experience in big situations. She threw an inning of relief in the Women's College World Series against Texas A&M. She winds and delivers. Tries to check her swing, cannot do it. So that'll even the count, 2-2.
Nice pitch on the outside corner there by Tom Alino.
So she winds and delivers. Slapped out, that's gonna go foul off the plate. So 2-2 still is the count. Jennings so far today, she does have a sacrifice. Slapped out to the short baseman, shortstop. Perez across the diamond to the first baseman, Washington, and we got one down.
Nice, easy. High chopper to the shortstop. She was running very well down the line. The shortstop, Brianna Perez, has a very strong arm, able to set her feet, make a strong throw to first base for the first out of the inning.
Leadoff hitter Rolletter steps up to the plate for Fresno State. She was hit by the pitch earlier in the game by Grauer, and she also had a sac fly RBI. So she's batting 361 on the season. Does what you want for a leadoff hitter. Gets on base, 489 on base percentage. Rolletter, the lefty. She's got her heel on one side of the box and her toe on the other. Fouls it off, a little excuse me foul ball. So, in your mind as a manager, what's a better stat, on-base percentage or batting average?
On-base percentage all the way, especially for your leadoff hitter. Maybe not necessarily for the people in the middle of your lineup, but your leadoff hitter's job is to get on base any way that they can, hopefully use their speed to get in scoring position for the batters in the middle of the lineup.
Tough pitch to take, but she took it, and that'll make the count 2-2. Rolletter is your prototypical leadoff hitter in the sense she also steals bases. 7 stolen bases thus far on the season.
Yeah, just what you're looking for out of your leadoff hitter. You want them to get on base and get in the scoring position any way they can.
Fouls it off down the line. 2-2 still. One out in the top of the fifth inning. Fresno State last inning with 2 home runs. So we've got a good battle here between the Bruins and the Bulldogs. Tom Elo with a pitch. Ground ball to second base, over to first, and we got 2 down.
That's not an easy play there. By the second baseman, Kylie Perez. Ball took a little bit of hop there on her. Took a little hop on her at the end. She did a good job staying down on that one, not taking her head off the ball. She was able to make the nice, easy throw. The first base for the second out of the inning.
2 outs. We'll go to the number 2 hitter. Castellon fakes like she's going to bunt, and she takes a pitch 1-0. They're going to appeal, and yeah, she didn't go. And there seems to be a little bit of an argument with the UCLA head coach. You know, last weekend, the UCLA coaching staff, it was interesting. They noticed a discrepancy on the lineup card provided to them. I'm trying to remember what team it was. That's a strike, 1-1. They actually found the error, and as Rachel Perez is throwing her perfect game, it was about the fifth or sixth inning, they noticed the error. They kind of let it go until the fifth or sixth inning. Garcia gets a runner on first base, and they go over and they say, hey, umpire, take a look at this. And it was a good notice because that batter was then out. Perfect game continues.
Yeah, that's a very good job by the UCLA coaching staff. Keeping an eye on that lineup and definitely using that mistake at the most costly time for their opponent.
Castellon so far today, she's walked. She also had a sacrifice, so 0-for-0, 368 average. Tom Elo, a little bit low for a ball. So that evens count, 2-2, two outs here in the fifth inning. Have you ever caught that? Have you ever caught that as a manager?
Absolutely. You're always looking for any advantage you can have to help your team win. Certainly catching your opponent making a mistake on the lineup can be a big one.
It seems so trivial, like, you know, not dotting your I or crossing your T. Kind of like, you know the intent, but at the same time, use it to your advantage, right?
Rules are rules. Sometimes coaches will make the mistake of filling out their lineup card differently than their dugout chart. I've seen that before.
Hard hit foul ball down the third base line.
So what their players are seeing in their dugout is actually different from the official lineup card that was turned into the game, and that is certainly an error that happens not very often, but one of the things you have to do as a coaching staff is check out what your opponents are turning in thoroughly every game.
Ground ball to Perez. Perez takes it on a hop, throws across the diamond, and that'll do it. So Tom Milo with a 1-2-3 inning for the Bruins. They lead UCLA lineup. It's 5-3 here in Cathedral City, and Rachel Garcia stepping up for the Bruins. So what all can you say about Rachel Garcia? Well, she's just probably one of the better pitchers in the country. She also hits 400.
Went 3-for-3 last game, had a couple RBIs, earned the win on the mound. As you can say, she does a little bit of everything.
So today, she's 4-for-4 with a walk, a couple RBIs, raising her average up to 400. She scored 2 runs thus far today. A little bit inside for a ball. So 2-1 is your count. The Bulldogs have had pitchers warming up in the bullpen all game. But Mejia has pitched her way out of a couple difficult situations. Garcia, she will single again into left field, and the Bruins have the leadoff hitter on.
Garcia staying hot at the plate. Not an easy pitch to handle there. Looks she was able to, Mejia was able to get a little bit inside on the hands of Garcia, but she was still able to fight it off. Didn't hit it as hard as she could, but it was enough to get it over the shortstop's head and just in front of the left fielder for a leadoff single.
So a pinch runner will come in for UCLA. We'll get the player in a second. But up to the plate right now is Bubba Nichols, who's 1-for-2. She had a double earlier today.
Number 7, Jenna Crawford.
Crawford will be the pinch runner for Garcia. And the right-hander Bubba Nichols comes in to face Mejia. So nobody out here in the inning. She starts Bubba Nichols off with a strike, 0-1. That's a strike. So Bubba Nichols is out of Merced. She went to Merced High School. She's a four-year starter at pitcher and shortstop. So yet another UCLA player who can pitch if called upon. Ooh, hard hit. Almost decapitates a UCLA third base coach.
He didn't get out of that one. Get out of the way of that one very easily.
Now, they don't in softball, they don't have the base coaches wearing helmets. I'm not sure that rule will be in place very long. I can imagine that, you know, somebody in the NCAA will, you know, tell coaches that they need to start wearing helmets.
Yeah, especially when you're getting line drives coming down there as hot as those ones are.
Nichols takes up. So 2-2 will be the count. Still nobody out. Runner on first base. Crawford is on first base, running for Nichols. Running for Garcia. Nichols with two home runs on the season. Two doubles, two triples. Hits that ball hard to the gap. Is that going to fall? No, good play by the center fielder Hernandez to track that down. And we've got one out.
Not a bad piece of hitting right there. She put a good charge into it. Didn't get all of it. Center fielder read the ball off the bat very nicely, able to drift to the left.
Number 21.
And make the catch for the first out of the inning.
Taylor Pack will step in from Sutter, California.
Northern California.
Yeah. When you hear about California history, you often hear about Sutter, California. Pitch is down 1-0. Pack, so far this season, she hasn't started a lot of games. She only has two at-bats today. She has two hits. But in this season, she has 23 at-bats. Her batting average is .522. I think there's a little bit of an error because they say her batting average is .522, but her on-base percentage is .500.
Yeah, I don't know how that would be. But certainly Taylor Pack taking advantage of getting some opportunities today, 2-for-2 with two doubles in this one.
And she has five doubles on the season and a home run. So she can mash for sure. She finds herself ahead of the count, 2-1 with a runner on first and one out in the bottom of the fifth inning. Mejia into her wind and pitches. Pack out in front of it, fouls it down the line to even the count, 2-2. Now for UCLA, what is their strategy here? Is a Pack who's got, you know, she's such a power hitter. Doesn't seem like small ball is really the strategy at all, right?
Yeah, not here with a runner on first base and one out. Right now, Pack with two doubles. They're going to let her swing away right here. Another double. Put runners in scoring position.
Grounder to the shortstop. Tough play across the diamond. Good play by the shortstop, Castellon, and we've got two down.
Yeah, not an easy play right there for the shortstop, Castellon, having to move to her right. This is a soft ground ball, had to get rid of it very quickly. Just in time to get the base runner Pack.
Number 46.
And really a tough hop on that. It wasn't hit that hard, but just to be able to transition on the run.
Yeah, absolutely. Her body was moving one way. She had to throw across her body. Wasn't able to get a lot on it, but got it over there just in time to get the out.
So Crawford's in scoring position at second, and Zoe Shaw stepping in. Shaw today, she's been on base twice. She's 1-for-2. In the third inning, she reached on an error. Also made one of the best throws that I think I've seen this tournament, throwing a runner out from right field to third, and in a play that, you know, is really going to end up being pretty big.
Absolutely.
That ball is going to fall into right field. It's bobbled by the right fielder, and the run will score. Crawford scores, and Zoe Shaw has an RBI single with two outs in the bottom of the fifth.
Yeah, right fielder might have not even had a shot on that if she did field it cleanly with the runner on second base. She's going on contact with two outs, and she was able to get that ball in right in front of the right fielder. And UCLA is able to extend their lead 6-3 here in the bottom of the fifth.
So a meeting at the circle. Mejia, she's battled all game. Just a couple batters away from getting out and keeping the game closer than it was. And it looks like UCLA is going to bring up a pinch hitter. Coming up for the Bruins, looks like number 10, Malia Quarles, who's out of Cerritos, California. Another very talented freshman, power hitter, born in Long Beach, California. Named first team all San Gabriel Valley League each and every season when she was in high school. Hit 526 as a senior with a school record 13 home runs.
Impressive. She's in scoring position as soon as she steps up to the plate, and that's what UCLA is looking for right here. One swing of the bat and breaking this one open.
Hard hit ball, but that's going to stay in the park to left field. Jennings over. She'll be under it. Makes the catch, and that'll do it. But UCLA adds a run. They lead 6-3.
When they already had a runner in scoring position, and that could have been a real momentum killer. Hard to say how that inning would have gone. They wouldn't have got thrown out of third base that inning.
But the tying run would have been coming to the plate. So.
Absolutely.
And speaking of runners on base, there's a base hit right there for McKellen. McKellen grounds the ball right up the middle. Doesn't do too much. She just grounds the ball right up the middle softly, and that's good enough.
Fresno State with a leadoff hitter on here in the top of the sixth. They're going to need a few more base runners, but certainly going in the right direction here.
So it looks like we'll get a pinch runner in. That would be number 16, Brooke Coates, out of Farmersville, California. So, and then coming up to bat is Haley Galvin. Haley Galvin came all the way over from Oklahoma. She started her career at Oklahoma State. Fouls it back, 0-1. Galvin today homered in the fourth inning. One of those no doubters. So Fresno State with two home runs thus far today. Find themselves in a three-run hole in the sixth. Tom Milo is low with that one. So Galvin is out of Fort Gibson, Oklahoma. So a 5'7 sophomore. Tom Milo into a wind, the pitch off speed and fouled hard down the third base line. So Galvin today, with that home run down the left field line, finds herself in a hole 1-2. There aren't any outs in the inning. Seems to be a meeting of the mind over there towards the circle. Well played game thus far for both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. Fresno State still battling here late in the ballgame, down by three, have the late leadoff hitter on. Looking to make something happen here in the top of the sixth.
Very good crowd on hand, mixed between UCLA and Fresno State fans. It goes, wraps all the way down the line to the entrance of Big League Dreams and around to the edge of the left field foul line. And that hit. That hit Galvin on the knee. That looked like it hurt. She's hobbling a little bit, but I think she'll be happy knowing that she's on base and the tying run's coming to the plate. And ouch, that does not feel good.
Yeah, not what Tal Molino wants to do right there after the mound meeting. The hit batter will bring the tying run to the plate here for Fresno State.
And Vanessa Hernandez already has homered in the game. She homered in the fourth. The Bulldogs had back-to-back home runs. Galvin is still over beyond first base, limping a little bit. I think she's going to try and gut it out, but we'll see. She is still limping, having a tough time walking it off. And it looks like we're going to get a pinch runner coming in from the bullpen. Looks like number 12, she is going to come in. And number 12...
Dolly Stevens.
number 12, Dolly Stevens.
Dolly Stevens stepping in, and Dolly Stevens. Well, there's a pop-up on the infield. Let's see. Washington calling everybody up, and it drops beyond her. And it ends up rolling foul. So Washington stabbed at it, couldn't quite make the catch. And luckily for the Bruins, it rolls foul.
Yeah, Fresno State really catching a break right there. That's a ball that should be caught. Ball landed in fair territory. Nobody touched it on the UCLA side. Once that ball hits foul and they grab it, it's a foul ball.
So UCLA very lucky on that play. Dolly Stevens coming in. She was from Palmdale, California. She's pinch running at first base and went to Antelope Valley College before transferring over to Fresno State. And at the plate for the Bulldogs, again, is Vanessa Hernandez. Tom Milo into her wind on the pitch, off speed. Hernandez unable to check her swing. So she's now down 0-2 with two runners on. Right-hander has a very open stance. Toe on one side of the box, heel on the other. Tom Milo winds and delivers off speed, and that was hit hard. I think that was a mistake pitch right there by Tom Milo.
Yeah, she left that one a little bit too up and over the plate. Not the pitch you want to make in an 0-2 count. Want to throw something out of the zone, maybe get the hitter to chase. That one caught way too much of the plate. She was able to get away with it with the foul ball.
Indoor wind and the pitch. A high chopper to Tau Talafua. She has one play across the diamond and makes it. Tough play on the big hop by Tau Talafua. The runners advance, and we've got one down.
Yeah, good decision right there by Tau Talafua. Having an out at any base. High chopper. Didn't allow her to get back to her bag to get the lead out, but she did have time to make the throw across the diamond for the first out of the inning.
Looks like we're going to have a pinch hitter in for the Bulldogs. Chase Lehong is stepping in. She's batting 250 thus far on the season, 1-for-4. So big opportunity for the Bulldogs. They have two runners in scoring position with only one out. Tom Milo into her wind and the pitch. Off speed, that's hit right to Brianna Perez. It looked like a single off the bat, but Perez showing the range and gets that, and we got two down.
Yeah, that's a big out for UCLA with runners on second and third. A lot of different ways that runner on third can score. The batter did hit it hard, but the shortstop was right there to make the play.
So it looks like we have a pinch hitter coming in, Dominique Jackson. Dominique Jackson from... she's number four, and she's from Chico, California, up towards your neck of the woods, Pleasant Valley High School.
Yep, same high school as Aaron Rodgers.
Dominique Jackson is a very big right-handed hitter, swings and misses right there. So she's a 5'9 junior utility player. So far on the season, she's batting 208. She's batting 276 with runners in scoring position. So far today, Fresno State is 0-for-4 with runners in scoring position. Sixth inning, this is a huge situation for the Bulldogs. Takes inside for a ball, 1-1. So UCLA in the game with runners in scoring position, 4-for-10. Bulldogs 0-for-4. And in a close game, that's the difference. Tom Milo twists and delivers. Swung on and missed. And it looks like she's doing something odd with her feet. Do you notice that?
Well, the thing I noticed right there, good off-speed pitch by Tom Molino. Caught the hitter off guard. She was definitely out in front of that one. Didn't look comfortable in the box. And as a pitcher, that's your number one job. Keep the hitter in the box uncomfortable.
A little bit high for a ball, 2-2. I was just noticing though, if you look at Jackson's feet, it's almost like they're happy feet. When she swung on a couple of those, they weren't, didn't seem like they were moving right. Could be wrong.
Let's see if she does it again right here.
Tom Milo gets her sign, winds and delivers. Grounder to Tau Talafua across the diamond, throws, and they got her. So Tau Talafua is able to get.
She has done a very nice job today, keeping her team in the ballgame.
He is only a sophomore, so this is going to be a really good experience for her coming a little bit later in the season when she's in a tough situation. Perez fouls off the bunt attempt, 0-1. Both of these programs will probably find themselves in the postseason. So experience against good teams will come in handy.
Absolutely. Got to win the close ones. Championship caliber teams win the close games. And this is a close one right here.
1-1 is the count. If you look around the Mary Nutter Collegiate Classic, you have a lot of Pac-12 schools, and that is a very deep conference.
Absolutely.
Two and one to Brianna Perez. Before the game, I got a chance to talk to them. A lot of the UCLA players are stressed out. They have midterms coming up. It's a very good academic school.
Yeah, you wouldn't know it. By the way, they're playing here today. They won the first game. They're ahead here late in this one. They're all business when they're here on the field.
So Perez ahead in the count, 3-1. Bruins would love nothing more than a couple insurance runs. Mejia into the wind and the pitch. Hit hard to right field. She might have hit it out of the park, and she did. Home run. Brianna Perez, and UCLA takes a 7-3 lead.
She got all of that one. That one was gone off the bat. High towering fly ball. Cleared everything out there in right field.
You know, we're here at Wrigley Field at Big League Dreams. I don't know the exact measurement to the foul pole in the back of Wrigley Field, but she almost hit it out of Wrigley Field. Put a pinch hitter up, number 42, Jelly Felix, which I still think is my favorite name of the tournament.
Jelly Felix?
Jelly Felix.
That's pretty good.
So she's wearing number 42, which of course is a huge number in relation to UCLA. Jackie Robinson's number when he was with the Brooklyn Dodgers.
Absolutely. One of the greatest of all time.
Jelly Felix is a senior, right-handed batter. Generally plays in the outfield. Swung on and missed, strike three. So McKellen comes in, gets a strikeout. Strikeout, that's her fourth on the season. And that'll bring up number 23, Aaliyah Jordan. Jordan today, she flied out to right field. She walked and struck out. McKellen misses low, 1-0. So Aaliyah Jordan now batting an even .500 on the season. 38 at-bats, 19 hits. Of those 19 hits, four doubles, two triples, and three home runs. Takes a strike, 1-1. Now for those people watching at home, if you look at a .947 slugging percentage, what does that mean to the average fan?
That means the hitter is getting themselves into scoring position quite a bit in their at-bats. They're getting extra base hits, possibly doubles, triples, home runs. They are players that are known to hit for a little bit of power.
How is that calculated? Means that they're in scoring position.
That's good. It's a good question, Wes. I was going to ask you the same thing.
I think we might ask Siri.
It's good. It's what Google's for.
So Jordan gets ahead in the count, 3-1. So we'll see what kind of pitch she gets right here. Leah Jordan, of course, just like we were saying, very powerful hitter. A little bit outside for a ball, and she walked. And it's funny when a power hitter walks, you can see it almost looked like Jordan was frustrated on that.
Yeah, she was. She was looking to hit. They're up by 4 runs here, so she doesn't want to walk. They're pretty comfortable with their lead here late in the ball game. She wanted to hit. It's a good opportunity when you're up by this much to be a little bit more aggressive in the batter's box. You don't have to take a lot of pitches. UCLA having base runners isn't the most important thing right now. The important thing is their batters continue to see tough pitches, have good at-bats.
So in to run for Jordan is Jackie Prober. Tau Talafua is coming in to hit, stepping up. She's a third baseman. So far today, she's 0 for 3, still batting .333 on the season. He's a little low outside for a ball, 1-0. So McKellen came in for Samantha Mejia. Bulldogs down by 4 runs, 7-3 here in the 6th inning. McKellen into the wind, and the pitch. A little bit outside for a ball.
And she wants to start throwing some more strikes here. Don't want to keep putting UCLA base runners on. One more walk would put a runner in scoring position.
For Garcia, who hasn't been retired today.
Do not want a runner in scoring position when Garcia comes up.
Down again, so that's ball 3 to Tau Talafua.
Savannah McKellen having problems finding the strike zone here.
So if you're the UCLA coaches, do you give her the green light?
With the 7-3 lead this late in the ballgame, I do give her the green light. She has one pitch that she should be looking for. That's the fastball up and down the middle.
That wasn't it. So she takes a 4-pitch walk, and Rachel Garcia is going to step up to the plate.
Yeah, not the person you want to see stepping up to the plate with runners on base. Garcia been very hot all day today.
So we're going to have a pinch runner in for UCLA. Imani Johnson has been in almost every game as a pinch runner. She's out of Carson, California, a junior. Extremely fast, scored last game. UCLA has 2 runners on here in the 6th inning, 1 out. And Rachel Garcia stepping in, who hasn't been retired today. She's also pitched and hasn't given up a run today. McKellen into her wind, she pitches. And that's a strike. She starts off Garcia with a strike. Garcia probably was taking since McKellen hadn't thrown a strike in a while.
Yeah, Garcia probably taking all the way right there. She walked the previous hitter on 4 straight pitches. But look for Garcia. She's going to be ready to hit right here.
There's a strike, so Garcia behind 0-2 with 2 runners on in the bottom of the 6th inning. Garcia batting .415 on the season. She walked and had 2 singles. Outside for a ball. 1-2 with 1 out here in the inning. So McKellen ahead in the count, a couple pitches to waste. Let's see what she goes with. McKellen delivers. In the dirt, good block. Brodner's done a great job defensively behind the plate.
Yeah, absolutely. The block right there prevents both runners from advancing and getting into scoring position.
So UCLA has a runner in scoring position with 1 out. Swung on and missed. Dropped third strike. Garcia is retired, and McKellen gets the strikeout.
That's a big, big strikeout for McKellen right there. Getting the batter, Rachel Garcia.
So Bubba Nichols will step in. She doubled in her first at-bat. Two flyouts afterwards. So McKellen looking pretty good. You look at these early stats, and it's not really a good idea to read too much into them, but I see 9.55 ERA. Again, and coming up against a UCLA lineup this good, I'm thinking to myself, well, this might not work out too well, and here McKellen has looked good thus far.
Yeah, she has good stuff. She throws, too many balls. Needs to continue to throw good strikes early in the count and get ahead.
And there's a strike right there. So 1-1 is the count. Here were two outs in the inning. Perez led off the inning with an absolute bomb to right field to give the Bruins a 7-3 lead. McKellen into the wind, the pitch, fouled back over towards Fenway. And it's going to be 1-2.
Yeah, nice pitch right there. She's working ahead. It's a lot easier to be effective when you're ahead in the count. Now in 1-2. She has a pitch to waste right here, trying to get the hitter to chase. Oh, we'll see what she does.
Outside for a ball. So 2-2 with two outs in the inning. Bubba Nichols is only a sophomore. She's 5'8 out of Merced. And she's listed as a utility player and a pitcher. I've seen her mostly play in center field. Big swing and a miss, strike three. So McKellen getting some
score looks. They are a good softball team. Don't let the score or the record fool you.
Skylar Broussard stepping in for the Bulldogs. Takes an off-speed pitch for a strike, 0-1. Broussard has 7 RBIs on the season, 4 walks, 11 hits. Tom Milo twists, winds, and delivers. Hard hit ball right to Kylie Perez, and we got one down.
Good job right there by Tom Molino. Getting the leadoff hitter out, she hit it hard, but right at the second baseman. And that's always nice to get the first hitter out in the inning.
So Jennings is stepping in 0-for-1 today. Jennings has made a couple really good plays out in left field. Tom Elo winds and delivers. Jennings kind of creeps up like she's going to slap at the ball. Pulls back. So 1-0. She's ahead in the count. One out. Fresno State down to their last two outs. That's a strike. 1-1. So Caitlin Jennings is from Rancho Cucamonga, California, home of the Rancho Cucamonga Quakes, Dodgers minor league team. I know you're a big Dodgers fan.
It's too bad what happened in last year's World Series.
Ugh.
A heartbreaker.
A heartbreaker.
Somehow I managed to go on.
For those people watching at home, I'm a Dodger fan. I'm actually wearing a Dodger jacket earlier. Casey Dill over here, a big San Francisco Giant fan.
Yeah, it's a tough loss. Hopefully it's not going to be another 100 years or whatever before they get back.
It's only 30.
Only 30.
1-2 the count. Away, 2-2 to even the count.
You got to go to a World Series game, didn't you, Wes?
That I did. That I did.
They're 1-0, undefeated when you're at the game.
It's going to, if they go again this year, it's going to be very costly for my family, yeah, buying World Series tickets.
You might have been the good luck charm. Don't want to point fingers.
Ground ball to Kylie Perez, and there's two down.
But maybe you not being at Game 7 was the reason they didn't win.
Well, we all know softball and baseball, it's all about streaks. You don't mess with a streak.
Absolutely.
So Fresno State down to their final batter. Rolletter is stepping in, the leadoff hitter. So far today, she was hit by a pitch, flied out to right field, and grounded out to the second baseman. Takes a strike to start it off, 0-1. So UCLA on the verge of going undefeated at the Mary Nutter Collegiate Classic in both weekends. Tom Milo, indoor wind, and the pitch. Another strike. So Fresno State, the Bulldogs, are down to their final strike. A little bit high for a ball, 1-2.
Didn't miss by much. Ty Molino trying to get the hitter to chase. Good plate discipline. Fresno State still down to their last strike.
Rowletter coming all the way from Wichita, Kansas to play at Fresno State. A little excuse me foul tip down towards the UCLA dugout, and we'll do it again, 1-2. Two outs in the inning. Fresno State trailing by four. They need base runners.
Absolutely. A lot of work to do right here. Back against the wall. Down by four with two outs and two strikes in this at bat.
Tom Milo's looked good so far. 3 2/3 innings, only given up a hit. Off-speed pitch. Tough from our angle, but that looked pretty good.
Yeah, very good pitch. If it did miss, it didn't miss by much. But I like the change of speeds right there. Going with something soft away. And very good plate discipline there by Miranda Rolder.
Ground ball to Tau Talafua. She goes across the diamond, gets her by a step, and that'll do it. So UCLA goes undefeated in the Mary Nutter Collegiate Classic for two weekends in a row. UCLA beats Fresno State in this one 7-3.